Father.
Who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thy kingdom, power, and glory, forever and ever. Amen.
No pressure though. No pressure.
Just a little pressure.
If you fuck up, you'll never do
There's
it.
There's no audio.
You'll never do it again.
That's the way it goes on Love's Train.
That's the way it goes on Love's Train. On three. One, two, three.
That's the way it goes on Love's Train.
Hello. What's going on, everyone? How y'all feel? I mean, Phoenix. How y'all feel? Thank you. Without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, the foreign exchange.
Y'all make some motherfucking noise out there. One time. Hey!
There's a war and your love's on the line, falling apart at the seams. And it's only the strong who survive, between the joy and the screams. But right there, right here now, such a familiar scene. Live, do we learn or just die under the weight of our dreams? I'm so lost when I'm away, trying so long to find a place. So I say, let's just call it home, cause that's wherever you are. Clouds in the sky, sunny days are rare, but I follow you almost anywhere. Right here, you can call it home.
What did the first foreign exchange show look and sound like? Because it sounds like it's very refined now.
It's not very refined. It wasn't that. The first gig, the first true, I guess, you know, foreign exchange gig in the way that we're doing it now. The first gig was at Highline Ballroom in New York. And it was 2008.
New York City, I said it, go, baby! Yeah.
It was definitely the first time headlining, if you will, like a show, and just, you know, bringing the crowd out to come see us, and just like Tay said, putting the band together.
I think there was no one else on that bill.
There was no one else on that bill. So it was literally like baptism by fire for all of us.
That first show was very much, as Nicolay likes to describe it, it was a ball of nerves. I mean, we were absolutely terrified.
It's interesting because there is like bootlegs of that show, and you can just hear, like, I mean, it's really good. In the sense that if you think it's the first time, it's actually really good. But like when you listen to it with the knowledge of the 6 years that we've done since, it's very interesting to hear where we were at that point in time.
And then the record dropped, and I remember I was actually out on tour at the time, with Little Brother, and Amy called me and she was just like, we're number one. And I was like, what was she talking about? She was like right now iTunes, like, we're number one. And I was like, what do you mean? We number one? She's like, nah, we have the number one R&B album on iTunes right now. And I was just like, oh shit.
What's up? Good morning or evening, friends. From time to time I wonder how much easier life could have been if I knew then what I know now. Hey. Feel so good, love's flying high.
I'm shining.
Feel so good, love's flying high.
You're beside me.
Feel so good, love's flying high. Flying high.
So I have to take the time to say, oh, I'm so thankful for a chance today.
Yay. Ooh, no more wasting time now that I know. Anywhere you lead me, I will go. Do 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 da da do do da 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 do do da da do da da do do da 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 do do da da do da da da. Phoenix, I need everybody to get one hand in the sky and sing it out. Come on.
Feel so good, love's flying high.
One time, a little louder.
Feel so good, love's flying high.
One time, a little louder.
Feel so good, love's flying high.
What's up? A little louder.
Feel so good, love's flying high.
You're beside me.
Feel so good, love's flying high.
You're beside me.
Feel so good, love's flying high.
You're beside me.
Feel so good, love's flying high.
What's up? What's up?
Feel so good, love's flying high.
My name is Christopher LaPorte. I am the owner and founder of Insert Coins Las Vegas. I'm so lucky and humbled to own what I own. Like, I own a bar where I get to play video games and have my favorite music and artists perform here. And I'll never forget that every single day I wake up. You've been to Vegas once, twice, three times. You do your excess nightclub, you do your strip club, you do your whatever you want to spend all your money on. But maybe at your fourth time that you come to Vegas, it's just like, you know what? Let me see what else the city has to offer.
Most people who come to Vegas for that experience. That is the appeal, you know, by way of movies and commercials and all these kind of things. And you think about Vegas 20 years ago, 15 years ago, you were washed up if you played in Vegas. It was a joke. To even think, like, once you went to Vegas, your career was over. So the fact that this city was able to turn that around and become the Mecca is awesome.
For 3.5 years that we've been open, every time we try to bring something in that I know I love, it's always like, oh, I hope Vegas knows what this is. And that's the biggest challenge that I have as a business owner here, is I know there are people out there who really appreciate good music.
When I heard Little Brother for the first time, it immediately took me back to De La Soul Is Dead, because it was smart and it was witty and the beats were amazing and it was funny as shit.
You know, we've had Brand Nubian, De La Soul, Jazzy Jeff, you know, we've had dope shows in here.
Those kind of bookings just don't happen. I would love to bring more of that here, because I don't think, obviously, that Vegas embraces anything soul-driven.
Brie, she made a big deal about them for a long time. Actually, when she first started working here, she was telling me, like, you know, this is my list of guys that I would love to have in here one day, whether I work with them at Insert Coins or somewhere else in Las Vegas. Like, I want to do something, and Foreign Exchange, top of the list.
I had told Chris, I'm going to get this damn show, because I knew at that moment how magical that show in here was going to be. when the show was placed at a different venue, the way that we all worked it out was I was gonna open there, and then Amy had said, like, we're gonna be there Sunday too. So how do you feel about Nicolay doing a set with, you know, over there the night before? And I was like, yeah.
It was an amazing night. That DJ set was booked because we were gonna be in Vegas, you know, the next day. I normally do like one a tour just to kind of, you know, just to have something else going on and have some fun.
I really see his style of spinning as kind of our style of performance. You know, the energy stays up. You know, he's interactive because he's nodding the whole time. He's introducing you to the music. It's almost like you're sitting in his studio and he's playing you music.
Everybody's got the song and dance about what it means to struggle and to go without. No one thinks that they're part of the problem. Yes, it's true. It's true.
People gonna get a 50 shade night. Recession, depression, fucking borderline. Everybody needs a little feeling and they do. They do.
And I was standing at the bar. I was faced away from the DJ booth. And I went and I took a sip of my drink and I heard the voice and I almost spit my drink out and I turned around and I was like, you gotta be fucking kidding me. Phonte came out of nowhere and just started doing a show.
To have those cats coming here to support Nicolay's show, everyone having a good time.
It was just the two of them laughing and smiling and him screwing around and doing, I was like, get out of here.
That was a good time though last night. They treated us right. It was good vibes.
Yeah, it was a lot better than the other, in the city that we shall not name.
The city that we shall not name, in which they would not let us in.
Yeah, he could get it to his own DJ gig. Like, cause, and like, yeah.
Issues with the dress code. They booked me in an environment, let me put it this way, an environment that was not conducive to our vibe.
Yeah, it was like,
and it started
so
with,
y'all need bottle service? I was like, oh shit.
Yeah, and then like, you know, our band showed up and they wouldn't get let in because they were t-shirts and sneakers. And it's just like, at that point I kind of knew, you know, it was just one of them real swanky clubs. I never ended up doing that one because I wasn't feeling it.
Insert coins, you're not told this has a foreign exchange.
The venue that we got booked in to do the FE show, there was some problems with permits or whatever it was, but either way, like basically the rug got pulled under that show, and so we had to kind of scramble.
I had a chat with the fantastic Amy Flint, and we had been chatting, you know, back and forth for a couple of weeks because I was going to be the opening DJ for the show when it was gonna be in a different location. Some things didn't work out, and it needed to be rerouted, and she asked me if I would take the show, and I did literally almost crash my car. Like, I had to pull over for a second.
Bree calls me up, I got the most amazing news ever. Like, what's up? She's like, Foreign Exchange is gonna do a show to Insert Coins. I'm like, get out of here. That ain't happening.
I knew it was gonna happen, I just didn't know how the hell it was gonna happen.
What's that, man?
You know, I wanted it to sound great in here. You know, I'm no auditorium by any means, not a theater, so we just made like a basement party of sorts and added a gang of speakers and, you know, which is gonna, let's make it happen.
If you look around the room, you know, it's all very hard materials in here, and acoustically there's nothing to absorb anything. We worked out the kinks. We had a couple of, you know, shows that were sounded like some really hot basement garage shit that didn't sound like amazing, but the energy was still there and it was great. And through trial and error and some fantastic sound techs, we were able to like dial it in.
I didn't know what to expect with Insert Coin. So when I walked over there, just even last night, to watch Nicolay spin, I had heard that it was more of a DJ venue, in which we have a spot like that in D.C.
I had never been to Insert Coins before, and the night before Nicolay had done a DJ session. So I'm like, okay, that's the stage? That's not no stage.
They was like, we usually don't do live bands. So I was like, oh, okay. So let's see what's gonna happen.
It's a long DJ booth. It ain't nobody's stage, right? So I'm saying, well, you know what? I mean, people have done more with less.
We put in a lot of new equipment in here just to make sure that the sound was respectful of, you know, the vision that these cats have.
So if I call out of that one, if I call out
I'll just be aware and watch.
Yeah, I want to know when you just count it off.
Okay, yeah.
So when we walked in sound check, and I saw, you know, I was like, oh shit, okay, well, you know, we good.
Good morning or evening, friends. From time to time, I wonder how.
We played another venue that had video games and stuff like that. I think that shit is dope. You know what I'm saying? For the cats who was born in the 70s, like myself, you know, who can get with the arcade games.
On a day like today, hey, gonna find my way to you.
Need a little more monitor.
On a day like today, gonna change my point of view. Hey, that's good on a day.
I think in its own way, it's kind of the calmer moment for me as long as all of the dots are connected. You know, there are moments where you have certain days and it is just shitstorm, you know, and but today was really smooth. I mean, the venue, Insert Coins, Chris and Charlie and Bree, they've all been really helpful and just trying to make sure that we had the best situation here.
Sorry, guys, let's do this for a pray up and make it happen.
Right over left,
right over left.
Just like a market like Vegas, I mean, they've been asking for us to come for a very long time, and this tour run, we tried really hard to make a few other places happen that we haven't had before, and San Diego, as well as Las Vegas, are two of those.
We all here?
Yeah, we're all here.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
I think it's going to be dope, man. I think it's going to be dope. And you know, they were saying it was like, you know, house party style. And I'm like, hey, shit, let's run it. That sounds right. Let's run it.
That was not grooving, Doc.
That was not grooving, Doc. On three. One, two, three.
That was not grooving, Doc.
I want to thank y'all for not just making music with us tonight. Thank you for making history. This is the first time the Foreign Exchange has ever performed in Las Vegas.
We really took a moment to say we're making history tonight because we have never played in Vegas. And at that moment,
let's go. Ooh, I got some things on my mind. Would you mind?
Now here's a thought, we're unprepared for love so filthy. No, I don't want, don't even care of that guilty. No doubt about it, we're nearly there. And on the inside, the guy of mine, I'm really scared. It's not what I know.
Take it up.
So what about the real possibility?
I think about the care that they take, you know, and making sure that they're not putting out bullshit just for the sake of putting something out every so often. And each time that I see like a show is being added, or you know, you see fans, you follow their Twitter feed, and there's fans all over the world that are like, when are you coming? When are you coming here? That music can do that, that people can get access to you from halfway across the world by you just doing what you do and being authentic about it. It's very inspiring.
Sing it up!
On a day like today,
gonna try me something new. Sing it up!
On a day like today,
my gray skies turn to blue. Sing it up!
On a day like today,
I'll find my way to you. Something new.
My goal, like my brass ring that I was kind of chasing for a minute, was just to be a songwriter. I didn't really want to be on stage or, you know, be the front man. You know, I wanted to write songs for other people because I don't care about the fame. I just want publishing. You know what I'm saying? Like, fuck this famous shit, nigga. You know what I mean? Like, let fucking goddamn Jonas Brothers or fucking Miley Cyrus, somebody cover my shit. Let them cover Laughing at Your Plans, nigga. I'm good. I was trying to cut stuff for male vocalists and I would just be singing and shit. And so essentially it's like, all right, okay, by the time I write the song, produce the song, do all the background vocals, just to give it to whoever and for them to just be like, nah, nigga, I could have kept that shit for me. You know what I'm saying? And so Leave It All Behind was just kind of the culmination of, you know what, like, in order for me to sell songs, you know, I'm gonna have to sing my own songs so people will notice me as a songwriter. If it would have been just, you know, my perfect world, all those songs would have been sold to other people.
All alone again in the morning time, the dawning time. I wonder how you've been and the time away. If it's all you say, sometimes it all seems so enormous. I wonder why we even try. Why do we even try? Feels like the world is coming for us, but this is my way to get by. Coming down outside. Lost inside this pain. Said I'm so lost.
Gonna lay my troubles to the side.
Lay down my troubles.
Just listen to the rain.
I mean, I remember doing a record with Mint Condition and, you know, they sent me a record and he was like, yo, we want you to rhyme on this joint. I was like, oh, word up, nigga, I got this all day. I did it. I was like, yeah, this is dope, I'm gonna do it. And I did it and I sent it to him. And then like the next day, Rick hit me, he emailed me. He was like, yeah, man, you killed that verse, shit is dope, but Stokely wants you to sing on it. I'm like, hold, nigga, who want me to do what? You mean like fucking singing notes in the goddamn stratosphere, Stokely? Like, why can't he just do it? Like, dude, I'm not, he was like, nah, man. Like, he was like, yo, your shit is dope. He was like, go in. I'm like,
okay. You can't blame it all on me tonight. Don't wanna walk away. Tonight I'll be the bigger man. You just keep on trying to push me away. But I'm not leaving, we got so far to go.
I wanna know.
You believe in me and keep away your pride.
I wanna know.
Cause I can't imagine you not by my side.
I wanna know.
You share with me your hopes and all your dreams.
I wanna know.
Cause baby, I love you for loving me. I found you, babe. So thankful for your way.
say to love and be loved in return. I tried to keep myself from you, but now I finally see the truth. Can't nobody love me like you do.
It took me a long time to find my voice and to find who I was as a singer. A rapper, I knew that, I mean, that's the back of my hand, blindfolded, I could do it, you know, all day. But as a singer, it's like, what do I do? Like, so, shit, so do I dress up? You know, so that was the first, those first runs, like, we used to all be dressed up. So I'm just like, ain't this what singing niggas do? Like, you know what I mean? They wear suits and shit, you know what I mean? Like, that was, so I went out and bought, like, all kind of suits, nigga. Like, you know what I mean? That was just, I didn't know. I really didn't know. I had no clue. As time went on, I gradually became more confident in my voice and in my own natural ability. It's like, you know what? Phonte as a singer can be whatever he wants it to be. If I want to go on stage and just like this, I can do it.
Las Vegas, I want to talk to you tonight about the power of music. Y'all ain't talking back to me. I said, Las Vegas, I want to talk to you about the power of music. Music, when done properly, can make you feel like everything is gonna be okay.
I guess I always view just my voice as just something just to get my ideas across. I never view myself as just the crooner, the R&B, just I'm gonna make love to you and pour honey on my chest and shit. Like that just, that shit won't never me, you know what I mean?
You got me feeling so unreal and now I'm losing my cool. You make me wanna lose myself in you and break all the rules. Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. If I ever lost this feeling, heaven knows what I do. And I'm not asking you to be an angel, just don't ever make me a fool.
Sugar, no cream, and no nothing in this bitch.
Oh, yeah. Become a singer. Don't become a musician. Get all this.
So we're Grammy nominated.
Yeah.
We go to LA for
the Grammys. With all the prestige that, and money, you know, that comes with that, right?
Right.
You know what
right.
I mean? Just we're, I'm swimming in it. We're swimming in it.
Swimming in money.
Point. I mean, we just swimming in it, baby.
All the way to LA. So we in LA, and because we were swimming in money, we weren't able to afford to bring our own bill.
I had my Porsche on lease at that time. And,
you know, the limo, all that stuff. So it's like we racked up a bill, couldn't bring the band out. And so we played with some local cats there that we were assured, like they were on point, they knew all the music. We getting ready to hit Daykeeper. It's not an easy song. It's not a particularly difficult song, but it's just you need to know it in order to do it. You need to know what comes where.
Yeah, you're not gonna be able to wing that one.
And drummer counts off, and on three, the bass player leans into me. He's like, "Yo, how'd that bass line go?" And that's when I really kind of knew we were in trouble. I'm just doing the best I can to kind of hum it right quick to him. You know, I mean, that obviously didn't go very far. By the time my man figured out the bass line, he was like, "All right, now that I know the bass line,
right.
I'm doing it." Yeah. That was a show that we all wanted to sink through the floor and just disappear. Like, cause it was like, it was a high prestige gig. It was like LA, Grammys, everybody was there. Questlove, Bilal,
Robert Glasper was there.
Layla Hathaway, everybody. Victor
and Nesby from Sounds of Blackness was there.
And Nesby was there, so it was just like, I mean, we looked terrible. Like basically, long story short. And that was the day that we decided that we are not going anywhere without like our guys.
One.
Great.
If you think it's expensive to hire professionals, wait till you hire amateurs.
Yeah, it's expensive in a very different way.
In a whole different way.
We've got a thing, and everybody knows. But the night is young, you pretty girl, I'm ready to go. Ride out, come on. Come on. Pretending I don't see you while we're on the floor. Wishing I could lead you into something more. Your eyes are feeding my curiosity. Why is this happening? Man, look. So I say, baby.
We've got a thing, and everybody knows. But the night is young, and we're dancing close. And I've been waiting, and imagining all the love we're making.
Goddamn, so I say, baby, you're looking good, but don't just take this as a sign. Wanna know what can I do to make you my love, make you my lover. Let's ride out, come on.
Don't wanna play cool,
play cool.
And I don't wanna play shy.
Don't wanna play shy.
Don't wanna break rules.
One time.
And I don't wanna waste time.
Waste your time.
It could be yours.
Be yours.
And
be my lover.
Be my lover.
At midnight.
Don't wanna
all across the world, B-boys and girls, we let them know that the party don't stop. Make dollars make sense, fly ladies and gents, we let them know that the party don't stop. Party people in the street trying to move their feet, let them know that the party don't stop. B-girls, B-boys, y'all make some noise, y'all let them know that the party don't stop, cause the party don't stop. Hands in the sky, hands up. One time for your mind. Here we go. Ooh, yeah. Can you feel it, baby? Ooh, I can feel you, baby. Ooh, just give me your love.
Just give me your love. Just give me your love, baby.
Cause I need
just
you, baby.
Give me your love. Just give me your love.
Oh, just give me your love,
just
baby.
Give me your love. Just
I'm gonna
just
step up my nigga. Y'all having a good time tonight? I know y'all having a good time. God damn it, I'm having a good time. Shit. They got my fucking pictures up here on TVs and shit. That shit is great. Feel like I'm in a goddamn Best Buy or something. We put on the goddamn Michael McDonald DVD, we can have a party. He came from somewhere back in it long ago. Michael Donald used to sing through his beard, goddamn.
Yes, he did.
That nigga was the greatest. Y'all be real, like, if the race war popped off, yeah, like, yeah. I would be Harriet Tubman for Michael McDonald.
Wise man has the power.
In choosing a band member, you know, it's, it really just comes down to just talent and then just can you hang? You know what I mean?
Hangability factor.
Yeah, can you hang?
Yeah.
I know you can sing, but can you hang? There's plenty of people that can sing. I can walk in any Baptist church and do this and hit, you know, bring the second soprano and bring her out on tour, but can you hang? And this is not a gig that is just not just a 1-2 easy peasy gig. It's not that the music is just entirely just difficult. It's not like, you know, we playing like, you know, fucking Steely Dan chords every night, you know what I mean? But it's very loose and it requires a person to put your own flair on it. And what happens with a lot of people when they first start this gig, they just kind of freeze up and it takes a while for them to kind of get into it because, you know, it is a lot. and it is a lot of energy, and it's very much interactive with the crowd, and every night is different. You know, we have a playbook, so to speak, but audibles can come at any time.
Waiting for the daylight, 'cause then she'll keep me in the safety of her arms. She never leaves me, and when the sun rises, she watches over me.
What the fuck is that?
You know how you can have like the app on your iPhone, the remote app, where you can control like your iTunes from your, did you read that? Somebody, I guess, hacked into it and was like streaming something from their phone, and it played over the club speakers. And I was like, what in the hell?
What got me is that I thought that was part of the show.
That was part of the show.
Yeah.
Yo, you just fucked up my night, nigga. Whoever the fuck you, what? Oh my God. I had the panic. The panties was about to come off. I had the panties. She had gave me the ass lift, and I was sliding the panties off, and the goddamn cell phone went off, and it was her baby daddy.
Yeah, that really took me out of my moment. I was very hurt by that. I was quite perturbed, as you probably could tell.
I'm going to pull out my Men in Black pen, and I'm going to put my shades on. And I'm just gonna delete that shit from all y'all memories. Just beep, nigga, I don't know, it's over. All right. Let's try this shit again without the fucking cock blocker that did that shit.
Like, we were, dude, you remember, like, we was fucking Cleveland, the fucking sound man.
Sound man started talking to us.
Yeah, on the mic. Like,
on the mic.
He was like, oh, yeah, I like that one. Yeah, do one more. Yeah, he like just.
He started interacting like as though that was gonna be a thing.
Right, as like, though that was gonna be a thing.
How many fellas y'all make some noise if you're here with your woman tonight? If you're here with your lady, make some noise with your lady. Word up. Love is in the building. Love is in the building. But I see a lot of y'all ain't clapping. So that means that you're available. And you're looking. So look, I'm going to give y'all a pro tip. Pro tip, fellas. I've learned if you ever want to do something so simple to help your lady, if you ever want to, you know, make her day and just show her that you care, you know what I mean? One thing that you can do to her is just sing to your woman, man. I'm telling you. If you sing to her, don't sing no fucking sappy, we always gonna be together, I love you forever.
Here I lay all alone, toss and turn.
I love that song, but that ain't what the fuck we here for. Fellas, you sing to your woman very tenderly, very passionately, but you sing to her the most sexually explicit lyrics you can think of.
In the beginning, it was something where it was kind of just something I did out of nervousness. Like, I would just be so nervous, but I was quick with my mouth. I could come up with shit. So, you know what I mean? And so I just be like, man, like, well, fuck it. Maybe if I just joke on some shit, they'll laugh.
Your woman got two voices she uses, all right? She has the voice she uses with you at home, and she has the voice she uses that keeps her employed. All right? So you call your woman on her job, and she answers the phone in her white girl voice. All right? Phone rings like,
thank you for calling Blue Cross Blue Shield. This is Jessica. How may I help you?
When she answers that phone, and if she's had a long, hard day, to make her day, you sing into that phone very tenderly, very masculinely. You sing to that woman.
I just wanna titty fuck you, girl.
Just titty fuck you, girl. Pull out them titties, 'cause I'm gonna
titty fuck you, girl.
titty, fuck your girl. In insert coins, pull out them titties on my titty, fuck your girl. Titty, fuck your girl. Skeet on them titties, rub it in, goddammit, on my titty, fuck your girl. Titty,
let's talk about some titties. Titties is a great diversion. Titties, ladies and gentlemen, let's talk about them. You know what I mean? And they would go crazy over that shit. I was like, well, goddamn. You know what I mean? So, you know, but I would really just be thinking about titties, and I just talk about them, and it was amazing how titties can change a room.
I titty fuck because I can. Sing that shit. Cause fuck it, sing.
Titty fucks because he cares.
One more time, I think they didn't understand. He didn't understand. Sing that shit one more time. Come on. I titty fuck because I care.
Titty.
Sing it, baby. I titty fuck because I care.
Titty. He titty fucks because he cares.
Make some motherfucking noise, Las Vegas. I care.
It's all about just taking people on a journey. You know, you can have a great song, but if it's in the wrong place on the album, it loses a little bit of its, you know, effect, you know. So, yeah, it's very much just like taking your listener on a journey. And I like to think of sequencing the show very much the same way.
I mean, you're carrying along people's emotions. Putting together an album or a project or a live show is much like putting together a dope mixtape. I mean, a mixtape like that DJs would do, where you know you have to keep the crowd captivated, man, and also you have to know your crowd.
One time, a moment to me that I thought was just like crazy. I saw The Far Side. They came out and I'm just like, okay, like, what are they gonna do? You know what I'm saying? Like, how are they gonna open up? Are they gonna open up with something from Bizarre Ride? Or I'm thinking they'll open up with like, oh shit, from Bizarre Ride. Something, you know, whatever. They opened up with Running. Running was the first song they played. And I was just like, yo, how arrogant, in a good way, you gotta be to open with one of your biggest records. I thought that was the ballsiest shit ever. I was like, holy shit, this is fun. And everybody lost it. And they opened with that and they kept them. They kept it going. And wouldn't they just blew it, like they kept it. It kept building. I was like, holy shit. And so that was just a moment with me, you know, in terms of sequencing our show. You know, conventional wisdom is that you're supposed to end with your quote unquote biggest record. And I don't think that's necessarily the case. I think it's just you can end or start with whatever you want to start with or end with. It's just the way you present it and the way you perform it.
I think all of us needed to really find, you know, how do we translate this music to a stage? How do we stay true to the records, but also add like a dynamic that, you know, works in a live setting and entertain people, you know, because you can't just play the music, you know? So I think these last 6 years, like every single show has been a learning process and still is, you know? We always jokingly say that every show is a rehearsal for the next one.
Four albums between us, and then, you know, you add in Zoe stuff and any kind of cover or just remixes, just anything. I mean, we could very much play a 3.5 hour show if we wanted to. So.
Which we don't.
Nah, we don't. Thank you.
Don't get it.
House your body in this place. It don't matter what's your race. It don't matter what's your face. Tonight's your night, today's your day. Las Vegas is where you roam. House music all night long. House music all night long. House music all night long.
Playing for the Foreign Exchange is a definitely a fun experience, and you know, sometimes musically a challenging one. Any anytime I'm out with the foreign exchange, I always come back home with tons of new music, stuff I've never heard before. So it's like an ear-opening experience.
One time, come on! Everybody, 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 clap your hands! Clap your hands! Just get an ass on clap! Get an ass on clap! Get an ass on clap! Love train, nigga, love train!
There were times in my life when I would stay lost in my mind. Change my world, it's you. There are times in my life when I want to run off in the night, never see the sun. But if there's a name I call with no shame, it's you.
One time for your mind.
Heart's beating, I'm weakening until you came into my.
Time when we came around in terms of hip hop, it was very much a thing where underground hip hop in a lot of ways was primarily white. You know what I mean? It was, you know, supported by, you know, a lot of kind of white college kids, and you know what I mean? It was just hip hop bars, 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 nigga, hip hop, hip hop, hip hop, hip hop. And so that was it. You know what I mean? So when we came out there, you know, two-stepping and playing soul shit and kind of bringing just that element of black, it's like, I didn't realize at the time, but it's just like, I'm bringing you into my world. Like, while I make rap music, it's not just rappity rap rap all day for me. Hip hop wasn't the first music that I was exposed to, you know what I'm saying? We grew up on soul music, Al, Stevie, Marvin, you know, all of that. And so we just started adding that into the hip-hop shows, and it was really just an extension of who we were.
Phoenix, Arizona, I want to ask y'all a question, man. How many of y'all can recall our very first album called Connected? How many of y'all can remember?
Looking back on Connected, I mean, the thing that just amazes me more about anything is just how much we've kind of grown since then. God, I wrote the majority of that record. I was, you know, 22, 23 years old, you know what I'm saying? And we were just all in the van, just laughing, just because you're an idiot in your 20s. If somebody walked up to you at 25, just be like, I know you think you know what you're doing, but you have no fucking clue. You wouldn't be, oh, what you mean? I know, I'm grown.
When I was 25, the turn up was, we going to the club, nigga, turn up. But now that I'm 35, it's like Netflix, nigga, turn up, nigga.
So much of Connected, you know, a lot of it I listened to, and I actually listened to it for the first time in a long, like in years, probably about a week or so ago. Just kind of, you know, prepping for the tour, and I mean, all I hear in it is the mistakes. You know what I mean? Like, I can't even, I was just like, oh. Like, I just, you know, I find it a hard record to listen to sometimes, as I do kind of all my albums. I mean, after I have perspective away from it, all I can't even enjoy them. All I hear is like, man, I could have did that better.
The more I give, the more you're wanting. Baby, I try real hard to make you happy. Maybe I don't say I love you like I used to. Please never doubt that I love you and I mean what I say.
Come on.
I'm right here. Won't you come around?
What's up?
Just come around. Lady, have no fear.
What's up?
I'm right here. Won't you come around?
you're gonna leave, just be sure. Cause all you want and needs won't be enough. I don't care what your friends have to say. I don't really care what it is they think. I'm working hard trying to make our ends meet. I'm not going nowhere, baby, please.
Good is the enemy of great. You know, it's not even about being bad anymore. I mean, we've been doing it so long, and we've just been doing it so much that to where it's like, it's almost impossible for us to be just flat out bad, because we're just so technically sound in each one of our crafts. So it's not about being bad. We don't even think about being bad. We're thinking about trying to be great. And this the tracks that are like, okay, this is good. This is really good. And someone else would probably hear this track and just faint. But nah, it's not great, or it's not for us. You know what I'm saying? And when you have people who like Nick and Zoe, you know, who just continually can produce at that high level, it really kind of spoils you with working with other producers. And you know, people just make excuses. It's just like, dude, me and Nick did our first album over the internet. We didn't even talk on the phone. What's your fucking excuse?
One time, hey, cause we're the get fresh crew, yeah. Ha ha, my man Charlie Dogger. One time, hey, been thinking, baby, I finally took the time. The wound is healing now, and now I realize
nothing you can say that could ever make me stay. Let me tell you, nothing you can do when it comes to me and you. She's just better.
Bring it back,
yeah.
Bring it back,
yeah.
Bring it back,
yeah.
Hands up.
I didn't know what they were gonna do. You saw how it went. All over the place. It's the live impromptu audience interaction with on stage within the band interaction. The fact that everybody is just happening in real time.
I love it. Freeze us, Jesus.
She's just better.
Yeah, yeah.
Do that, that thing.
Sing it out.
Yeah.
She's just
do that, that thing.
Sing it out. Love it, frees us, Jesus!
Foreign Exchange's history in regards to, you know, coming to a market that they haven't been to before. It meant the world to me to look around, to see everybody's faces singing along with all the words and hands in the air and just like, you know, I mean, they took them to church for 2 hours. It was beautiful, and this was the church.
I said when I woke up this morning, when it woke up this morning, sometimes I don't even have no words, you just gotta just coming on out, just But I heard a voice.
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 And the voice said, nigga.
The voice said, nigga.
My nigga, my 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 nigga.
For us, it was just important to come to Vegas. Like, yeah. We've never been to Vegas.
We had to plant the flag. Yeah.
And whatever the outcome is, like, when you do cities for a first time, especially cities that are not, like, you know, New York or L.A. or Chicago, Like, you just got to go out there, show the people that you exist, show the people that you can do your thing, even if it's 10 people or like 50, yeah. Whatever.
Obviously, like, I'm really happy if we have sold out nights, but sold out doesn't necessarily mean that a market isn't there, or doesn't mean that fans aren't there, you know. And there's a lot of cities, you know, a lot of cities that we go on tour with, you know, it's not always a situation where, you know, we're coming in with all sorts of big guarantees. You know, it is us putting our money down to make these shows possible. You know, that's where I would say we put our money down to be there for the fan, to make it possible for the fan. And, you know, and you may be in a location where only 200 people come out, but dude, like, sometimes it's like, wow, that's 200 people. Who knew that we had 200 people in a market? You know, and just by going once creates a new opportunity for us to go again. And I feel really happy when we have successful evenings like that.
I love it, frees us, Jesus.
She's just bad.
Sing it out. Sing it out. Sing it out. She's just bad. Sing it out. Sing it out. Sing it out.
She's just bad.
Sing it out.
Sing it out.
Sing it out.
She's just bad.
You gotta have people start spreading the word.
Yeah.
You gotta plant that seed early and just have many people show up, you know, y'all are gonna be my new representatives. Like, y'all go and spread the word and let people know what happened here tonight. You have to make that investment in yourself.
Foreign Exchange, Las Vegas, we fucking love y'all. Keep on singing,
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 keep on singing.
Let's go.
Hey.
She's the light of the world, and I try to keep the cool, but she knows it. Yeah, she knows it, baby. Yeah.
Hey.
And if I ever
made up. Nice show, baby. Good reason, man, brother.
That was fun shit.
Oh yeah.
You spoke.
Do
cool,
this.
Right?
Yes.
Yo, thank you for the best fucking show I ever had in my four walls, yo.
Brother.
I love all your blessings, yo, for real. Like, meant a lot to me to have just good fucking music in Las Vegas, because that shit don't exist. So next year when I see you guys again.
Yes, indeed.
Someone love you back.
What's up?
Don't get in the way. Hold it back. Don't wait.
Hey.
Ooh, don't wait. Ooh, don't wait.
I got the glow, nigga. Let's go.
If someone loves you back, don't get in the way. Don't hold it back. Don't wait. Ooh, don't wait. Ooh, don't wait.
Bring it out.
Yes, this is, Sweet Session is still on the budget.
Oh, shit. As we are all on the budget. Hey, yeah, yeah.
We don't see what's behind the curtain.
Oh, yeah. Brother, you little love flying color, you swirl. Y'all recorded, what's the studio look like? Really? You don't see the studio? Shit. Nah, yeah, brother. We all on the budget. Don't get it fucked up.